Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. In this video I am going to continue the Spark installation. Okay, so in the last video we downloaded the Spark binary files. Okay, let me minimize the recording window. Okay, thank you. So basically I downloaded the Spark 2.4.4-bin-2.7. I just downloaded the compressed file and uncompressed it. Similarly, I uncompressed SBT as well as Scala. Okay, now all the binaries are available. Now we want to change the configuration in the Spark and complete the installation. Okay, so first step is just navigate to the Spark, the folder, uncompressed folder. Okay, and then just open the bashrc file, which is the environment where you can set the environment variable. So I am going to set the Spark ohm as well as Scala ohm and SBT ohm. Just open this. It may ask you, if you open with the sudo permission, it may ask you for the password. Just provide your password, sudo password, root password, and then you just scroll down. So when you open this bashrc file, the beginning of the file you will see these kind of lines. Just scroll down. So in the bottom, so I already added Hadoop component and Hive component. So you see the all this environment variable. Just append this environment variable for SBT ohm, Scala ohm, and Spark ohm. Just provide the path, the correct path where your uncompressed Spark binaries are available. Then just path equal to $path:$spark-ohm/bin. Okay, then you just save it. Actually I opened using the nano editor. In the nano editor, just control O just to write. Okay, and just control X for coming out of the bash command. Okay, the nano editor, sorry. Now what we are going to do is just go to the config folder, which is inside your uncompressed Spark folder. You will have a conf conf folder, which is a which has configuration files inside that. You just navigate to that. Then you have to create a Spark environment file, which is a spark-env-sh from the template file, which is spark-env.sh.template. So how we are going to do? Just copy. Cp is a copy command, the template file followed by the file which you want to create. So then I will open that environment variable. I am going to set two environment variable. One is a Spark master host, which is my local host, because they have it's a single node Spark cluster. Okay, so I just will give the local host as a master host name and a Java path. Okay, so one thing I want to mention, just save it. One thing I want to mention, in this scenario I already installed Hadoop in my VM, then I'm installing the Spark. So if you are directly installing a Spark, you need to set the passwordless login, okay, to interact this different Spark process need to interact with each other. So you need a passwordless login. So just do that. That step is mandatory if you are directly installing Spark without Hadoop. Okay, so if you want to follow that, you just follow my video, Hadoop installation video. I told you the steps how to create a passwordless login. Okay, now we created the environment variable. Okay, the Spark environment, Spark master host as well as the Java home in the Spark environment file. Now next stage is to create a there's a file called slaves, where you need to specify the your worker node host name and IP address. Just copy from this the template file, which is a slaves.template to slaves. Okay, then open the file, and by default there will be localhost. If you want to provide the IP address, you can provide. I just keep as it is because I am just using a localhost. So then after that, there is a one more configuration file called spark-defaults.conf. So I want to create that file from the template file. I just run this cp command, copy command. So the configuration, the Spark default configuration file is created. I open using the nano editor. I'll just put the Spark master URL, which is this is the spark colon slash slash localhost dot 7077 is the default port number. Okay, so this means that I am going to use the Spark standalone manager. So Spark can run on any cluster manager. So Spark comes with the standalone cluster manager, or if you want to use if you have Hadoop already, if you want to use Spark Yarn as a cluster manager, you can go and use it. Okay, so just to start with, I'm just using a Spark standalone cluster manager. Okay, so then after this, you just save this file. Okay, now all this configuration is done. Now we want to start the Spark processes. Okay, so before running Spark processes, I'll just go to the main uncompressed folder of Spark. Then I'll just type JPS. So you see, all my Hadoop processes are running. So data node, name node, resource manager, secondary name node, node manager. Now I want to start the Spark master process. Okay, which is a master. So when you run this as sbin slash start master.sh, it is going to start the master process, and it's, you see that master process started. Now I'm going to start the slave process, which is a worker. So I'll just run this command called sbin slash start slaves.sh. So it has started the slave process called worker. Now the cluster is ready. The single node Spark cluster is ready. Environment is ready. Now we can actually type a PySpark, because I'm going to start a new series on PySpark tutorial. So I just type PySpark. So it will launch a PySpark CLI, command line interface, where you can go and write the Spark API, use code using the Spark API, using the Python. You can do a lot of analysis using the Spark API. Okay, so with this, I've installed Spark 2.4.4 version on top of the virtual machine, which has Ubuntu 18.04 and also Adobe 2.9.2. Now I'm going to complete this Spark installation. See you in the next video. Thank you so much, friends.